Hello everyone, this is The Binge List, in which I tell you about a variety of shows and films that I've loved across a variety of channels available on Tata Sky Binge. Let's start with my current favorite, Gulag Season 2 on Sony Live. This 5-episode show proves yet again that you don't need big stars, big budgets, or even high drama for terrific storytelling. Like the first, the second season also focuses on the Mishras, a middle-class family living in a small town in UP. The Gullak, who plays the Sutradhar, once again tells us that these are kisse, not kahani, meaning anecdotes, not stories. So one episode is titled Kirana and another Bijli Ka Bill. Santosh and Shanti Mishra and their two sons, Annu and Amana, ordinary people living ordinary lives. But director Palash Vaswani and writer Durgesh Singh locate the humor and roiling emotion in these relationships. The second season maintains the laughs but also delves deeper into uncomfortable truths and buried resentments that reside just beneath the surface. In episode 2, Shanti, who works tirelessly to keep her family together, finally tells the men in the house what it takes. A few episodes later, Anu's frustrations with his own failures make him lash out. These scenes have an unvarnished truth that will bring tears to your eyes, but they aren't staged like climactic confrontations. They're moments of pain that every family must endure. And that's the beauty of this series, that it feels familiar. The affection and bickering and aspiration for a little more is basically ghar ghar ki kahani. All of us will see something of ourselves reflected in the Mishras. The sparkling writing is enhanced by the stellar performances. Jameel Khan and Gitanjali Kulkarni are wonderful as Mr. and Mrs. Mishra. He has a gentle charm. She, even when angry, radiates this ferocious love for her home and family. And the boys, Vaibhav Raj Gupta as Annu and Harsh Meyer as Aman, are a great foil for each other. They're constantly fighting, but the strength of their bond shines through. Watch out also for how Palash uses the spaces of the house where most of the action takes place. We come to know it intimately. The washing machine in the courtyard, the small kitchen and the bedroom that the boys share. There's a scene in which Aman, who's studying for his board exams, describes how the sound of the jhingur helps him to work through the night. It's a beautiful little detail that adds a touch of poetry, which is what makes Gullak so special. You can see it on Sony Live. My next pick is a 2019 Telugu film called Jersey. You might have heard the name in connection with Shahid Kapoor, who's playing the lead in the Hindi remake. That film is supposed to release sometime this year, but before that happens, I urge you to find the original. Jersey is the story of a man who spends much of his life dealing with failure. Arjun is a talented cricket player who quits the game in his 20s and then attempts to revive his career when he's 36 years old. The scenario might remind you of Ashwini Iyer Tiwari's Panga, in which Kangana Ranaut played a 32-year-old Kabaddi player who tries to make a comeback after motherhood. It's an impossible dream, but the difficulty of the ascent only makes the climb more memorable. What sets Jersey apart from the standard sports film is that so much of it focuses on Arjun's struggle to keep his fledgling family together. The script, written by director Gautam Tenori, hopscotches back and forth in time. For the first hour, we see flashes of the star Arjun was on the cricket field, but mostly we see his failure off the ground. He's been suspended from his job, he isn't much help to his wife, whose job is keeping their family afloat. Their relationship, which started as a passionate love affair, is now strained to breaking point. The only joy in Arjun's life is his young son, who adores his father unconditionally. Arjun is a difficult man. He's frustrated by his circumstances, unable to either be a good husband or a good father. Tenori isn't afraid of making him occasionally unlikable. The director and actor Nani, who plays him, construct Arjun as a human hero, which means that he gets his whistle-worthy moments and slow-motion shots on the playing field, but we also see him stumble and break. Nani finds this sweet spot effortlessly. The actor carries the film with his terrific performance. Watch out also for Shraddha Srinath as Arjun's wife Sara, and especially Ronit Kamra as his son. Tenori uses Ronit's charm and innocence skillfully without overplaying it. Jersey is unapologetically dramatic. The story might stretch believability, but it never stops being emotionally convincing. At the end, you'll be inspired and weepy, which is a great combination. You can see the film on Z5. If you're a fan of swoony romance, then I recommend Sylvie's Love on Amazon Prime Video. The lovely Tessa Thompson stars as the titular Sylvie, who meets Robert, a saxophone player, in her father's record shop in Harlem. The story spans several years from the late 1950s to the early 60s. Robert and Sylvie meet and separate again and again through success and failure, heartbreak and regret. The narrative has drama, coincidence, sacrifice and moments of giddy, gorgeous love. When Sylvie and Robert did this slow dance on a street, I thought somebody in Bollywood needs to remake this. Director and writer Eugene Ash goes big on emotion. But the film doesn't veer into corny because the sentiment has depth and the performances are strong. Namdi Asamoah as Robert has an inherent decency and charm, and Thompson's expressive face reveals the many facets of Sylvie. The film is sumptuous looking with period details and a costume design by Phoenix Mello. Ash and DOP Declan Quinn revel in the colors and beauty. It's designed to sweep us off our feet. Life's too short to waste on things you don't absolutely love, a character says in the film. The sentiment isn't new, but Sylvie's love makes you consider it again. This is an old-fashioned film in the best sense of the word. My discovery of the week is Train to Busan, also on Amazon Prime Video. Even if you aren't a fan of zombie films, I highly recommend this one. It's unexpectedly emotional and even poetic. I know that sounds improbable, given that the subject matter is undead people eating other people, but director Yeon Sang-ho uses the horror movie trope to explore family dynamics, greed, fear, and what constitutes a true hero. Most of the film takes place on a train that's speeding toward Busan in the middle of a zombie apocalypse. Sang-ho builds suspense and terror. The action sequences are terrific, but he never forgets the human element, which is what makes this film so impactful. I was teary by the end, and how often does that happen in a zombie film? Do watch. That's all for this week. I'll be back next week with more recommendations on the binge list. You can watch all these shows and movies with the Tata Sky Binge subscription. To know more, search for Tata Sky Binge or click on the link in the description below.